In this topic, we're going to talk about resiliency. And particularly, we're going to talk about how to design your application to be resilient. Again, key topic when we're talking about the cloud is being able to be resilient. I mean, that sounds like a kind of a loaded term, right? Because everybody wants their application to be resilient, right, Mark? I mean,
absolutely.
We don't want to design an application that just goes down. Yeah. But there's a couple key points to remember, especially when you're dealing with cloud infrastructure or even the third-party libraries that you can interact with or SaaS-type applications. And so some of the key things to think about are how we handle transient faults. And when we talk about transient faults, let's define what that means a second. Transient faults are what happen as a result of us running on commodity hardware in the cloud. We can't 100% guarantee every time that we hit call a service, every time that we call a service bus, every time that we go to access storage in the cloud, we cannot 100% guarantee how quickly that's going to happen. Because we're dealing with such a massive scale in the cloud, we have to be able to design for those little kind of bumps along the road. And that's what transient fault handling is all about. And along with transient fault handling is this notion of a retry policy. And some of this stuff is a little bit like common sense, but you have to kind of see how it fits together into a solution and how it will integrate into your solution. Customers, typically, here's what usually happens in the field. A lot of customers will be out there and they'll be running their application that they built 10 years ago. They have a tight coupling, they call into things and they don't have, maybe they have exception handling wrapped around it, but they don't have a notion of a retry policy. Because they say, well, if the database is down, the database is down, we just have to stop. We have to abort whatever we're doing. But in this case, no, it might not be down. It might just take another 500 milliseconds in order for that connection to complete. And so it's important to understand those things. And that's really the bumps in the road that you see out there with customers using these applications. So if we have a design where we have, very simple here, I have three icons on the screen, but we have our user over here that's basically going to be calling into an application. So this is a user's workstation on the left side. He's going to be calling into an Azure website in this case. And that Azure website maybe has to do some back-end processing. Great way to decouple the application is to take these things that require, you know, maybe seconds to complete and kind of pull those off to the side and into a queuing mechanism, and that's where Service Bus kind of fits in. But if we forget about that for a second, so we call into this web service, we say, okay, it's going to call into Service Bus. So the end user is still sitting over here waiting. He's over here like, what happened to my request? Okay, I called in here 250 milliseconds ago. What's happening? Let's say the Service Bus over here for some reason is taking a little bit longer. Let's say it's taking 750 milliseconds right now because there's heavy load on it in the region that you're at. Maybe things are being moved around in that region. So we have some sort of a delay that's happening there. Now we don't want to immediately just like reject this back to the user and say, okay, we can't complete the request. That's it. You have to retry later. The user's not going to have a good experience with that. They're going to say, why is the application always down? This cloud thing's not really resilient. I thought you said this was going to be the future. But really what we need to think about is in this application, the key point about this application is what do we do whenever we have these kind of exceptions? So if we took a look at that and we said, okay, so when we call in here, if we have a slow connection, let's say it's taking a little while longer, this guy's sitting here waiting on that connection to complete or that transaction to complete. So if he says, okay, I'm going to wait for 10 seconds. And if I don't get a response back in 10 seconds, then I'm going to go ahead and back off. And so we call these exponential back off. So if we said, okay, we waited 10 seconds originally, actually it might be more aggressive to say, let's wait 1 second to begin with because we think the world is good. It's gonna complete really fast. So if we waited 1 second and then said, okay, that didn't happen. We didn't get our transaction completed. Then we go into an exponential back off and say, let's wait 10 seconds. Okay, so now we're gonna wait 10 seconds. We're still holding here at this application. The end user's got the little spinning wheel over here. He's waiting for whatever this is to complete. So we wait for like 10 seconds, and if we say, okay, that's enough, we can't deal with it, we could the next time when we come in here just say, let's throw an error and just put it back to the user. Or we could say, you know what, the user expects this because he's uploading a gig of data. For some reason, maybe he's uploading a large picture. And so the user might have an expectation that, yeah, that is going to take a little while. I understand what's going on. And so maybe we back this off to like 30 seconds before we try. And really defining this policy of like how many times we wait, how many seconds that we wait, and this notion of an exponential back off, that's really key to the transient fault handling and the retry policies. And so it's a key thing to remember again about scaling that application in the cloud. This is a fundamental application issue. If you were running this on premises, you probably should have been doing this all along. That's a great point that comes up a lot when we do these application architectures in Azure. We put these pieces together and we say, don't worry about the storage system. You know, we have a storage system in Azure. Don't worry about the queuing system. We have a queuing system in Azure. But you really need to understand how these things fit together. And that's kind of the point of these architecture sessions, is to show you how they fit together and what are some of the bumps you would hit. And this is a very important one. And so with that, that will wrap up this topic on the transient fault handling and retry policies in Azure.